friends, today we learn about, today our topic is disease of rice, and in this topic we learn about disease of rice, and today in this topic we learn about blast disease of rice. And blast disease is very important and common disease in the world, and high amount of rainfall and nitrogen is needed for this disease. So high amount of water and nitrogen is needed for blast disease of rice. You can see this is blast disease of rice. In this picture you can see blast disease of rice. And now we learn about symptom. This is a elliptical whitish gray lesions on dark green to reddish brown margin. Elliptical, and you can see in this picture elliptical whitish to gray lesions with dark green to reddish brown margins up to 2 cm long from the leaf scan. Polish and kill the leaf. Or you can say like this, after leaves on, this is effect leaves this blast disease. Effect leaves on these diamond shaped two gray or reddish brown lesions with reddish brown border, reddish to brown border. You can see in this picture reddish to brown border and brown lesions. The lesion may enlarge, coalesce and heal them entire leaf. You can see in this picture this is diamond shape, some call this is diamond shape and some call this is elliptical shape, some scientists. Okay, now we see next symptom is blast also affect the leaf color. This it may kill. This is color, not color. Blast also affect leaf color. This is leaf color. Leaf color. And what is leaf color? I will see you. Actually this is leaf color. Okay, leaf color. This is leaf color. And when blast affects in leaf color, this is color blast, then it may it destroy whole leaf. The third reason is the stem node. There should be a stem and stem nodes. Occasionally the internodes which at headling may result in the production of white panicles and breakage of the stem at the infection node. Sometimes it affects nodes and internodes. Okay, this is nodes and this is internodes. This is node. Okay, and this is internode. So the stem and stem nodes, occasionally the internodes which at the heading may result in production of white pinnacle or breakage of stem at the infected node. It affects leaf color, leaf, node, neck and parts of pinnacle. So we should identify what is leaf. We all know what is leaf and what is collar. Collar, we see it before. This is polar, the joint of tulip. Here is an what is polar node is here joint of two stem. This is node and neck. What is neck? This is neck and the neck of the rice plant. Refer to the portion of the stem that rises above the leaves and supports the seed head or panicle. It supports the seed head and panicle. This is the node. This is the this portion, and this supports the seed head. This is actually the neck. And you can see here the four types of blast: leaf blast, collar blast, neck rot, and panicle blast. The inflorescence of rice plant, borne or terminal shoot and thus called as panicle. So what is panicle? Panicle is inflorescence of rice plant, borne on terminal shoot and thus called as panicle. The inflorescence of rice borne on terminal shoot and thus called panicle. So what is panicle? This is the panicle. You can see here the panicle base is the neck, and the panicle base is neck. Okay, and the real panicle is here. This is panicle. The blast also affect in panicle. Okay, the infection of panicle next occur early. If panicle neck occur early, the grain do not fill and there is no grain. Okay, if the panicle infected late, if it infected late, panicle neck is infected late, it become filled, grain become filled, and because of the weight of the grain, the base of the panicle break and panicle drops. You can see in this picture panicle blast. Okay, most destructive symptom of the disease is called neck rot and neck blast and panicle blast stage. What is the most destructive symptom of this disease? Those are neck rot and panicle blast is the destructive form of this disease. Okay, and what is pathogen of the blast disease? What is the pathogen of the blast disease? The pathogen name is Pyricularia oryzae. What is the pathogen? Pyricularia oryzae. You can see this pathogen. Actually, this is see under microscope. Pyricularia oryzae. The fungus produces simply gray conidiophores. This is why we can see a gray color in infected leaf. The fungus produce simple gray conidiophore and pear shaped. This is pear shaped. Pear shaped and septate conidia. Conidia is septate of Pyricularia oryzae. They produce toxins such as pyricularin and alpha picolinic acid that seem to contribute to the development of rice blast. Now see development of the disease. So at first you have to know some things. In topic conidia present in the air, pathogen attract as mycelium and conidia. Pathogen attract as mycelium and conidia. And the fungus release conidia during the period of high relative humidity. Okay, so high relative humidity and pathogen attract to mycelium and conidia, and conidia present in the air, this three line is important. Okay, how now we'll take a look in how the development of this disease occurs. First, the conidia become airborne and landing on the rice plant. Okay, first you see it is airborne and landing on the rice. Okay, it's airborne and landing on the rice. First it's occur, and then the landing of produce mucilage. Okay, and when it produces lots of mucilage and leaf and stem surface are wet, and wet is necessary for spread of this disease, we proceed this. Okay, it produces mucilage and the leaf become wet. Now the conidia germinate, then wet, it become wet, the conidia germinate and the germ tube produce. Okay, the conidia germinate and this is the germ tube produced, and so the fungus penetrate plant surface and enter through the stomata. So plant surface, it can penetrate through plant surface or it can enter through the stomata of the leaf. Now see in the picture, it penetrate in the host cell through stomata or through the leaf surface. Okay, production and accumulation of melanin in the acrosorium cell. Melanin in acrosorium cell was seen to necessary for the successful penetration. When you see melanin in the acrosorium, we see mature acrosorium melanin. When we see this is young acrosorium, this is mature acrosorium. When we see melanin on the acrosorium, then it is confirmed it is a successful penetration. Production of the accumulation of melanin in the acrosorium cell was seen to necessary for the successful penetration. And now, rice seedling and young leaf and the stem tissue are more susceptible than older plant and tissue. Rice seedling and young leaf are more susceptible than the other plant and tissue. Seedling and young leaf, so which is more susceptible? Seedling and young leaf are more susceptible. And the next is the optimum temperature new blast lesion appear within 4 to 5 days. In optimum temperature it takes 4 to 5 days for appears. Weight and her relative humidity, new ponidia produces and released within hour. When high weather and high relative humidity present here, the ponidia produces and release within hour. Okay. Now rice plus is favored greatly by high nitrogen fertilization and prolonged leaf wetness, night temperature around 20 degrees Celsius. So what is favored for the blast disease? The Pyricularia arising, what is the favored situation? The high nitrogen fertilizer, prolonged leaf wetness, okay, leaf wetness, nitrogen, high nitrogen fertilizer, and night temperature around 20 degrees Celsius is favorable for the Pyricularia oryzae. Now we should control the disease. How can we control this disease? We can plant resistant cultivators which are produced by scientific research. Okay. Control is aided by early planting. If we plant early our crop, then we can control the blast disease. Nitrogen, keeping nitrogen fertilizer to minimum necessary. We apply nitrogen fertilizer to minimum necessary. We do not use more. Okay, using fungicides. We can use fungicides and most recently systemic fungicides. An experimental pre-plant solid application of silicon containing basic ground granulated blast furnace slag seems to reduce the lice blast in some agents. So we can apply these to reduce this disease. Thanks for watching. If any information helps you, subscribe this channel.